Hi, I'm Dr. Stephen Davis at Davis Cosmetic Plastic Surgery. Have you ever thought about, does the royal family get plastic surgery? Well, recently, one of the topics that I had an opportunity to discuss on the Daily Mail program was talking about areas of the world where plastic surgery is maybe not talked about as much, but you know for a fact that certain people are getting things done so they can look better. And one of the fascinating things is people really always want to know what's going on with the royal family, right? Well, we know for a fact that Sarah Ferguson, the Duchess of York, she actually has come out to talk about things that she's had done. And one of the things that she actually talked about was she loves the idea of lasers, because lasers allow her to continue to erase fine lines and wrinkles in a non-aggressive fashion. So obviously she's getting some laser procedures done, but she's actually commenting on that she has to continue to go and do it more frequently, because she does understand that every time you do one of those lasers, you're actually causing your body's own collagen production to be stimulated. So it's not so much about what you're seeing right then and there on the skin surface, almost like you're sanding down the wrinkle, but over the course of about 3 to 4 months, you'll see that area start to build up some thickening of the dermis, which makes that crevice or that indent not be as deep any longer. And if you do it over a good period of time, you can actually see the progression of going from real wrinkled skin to much more smoother skin without having the real deep downtime that you may have thought you needed to have with one big gigantic flamethrower where you're going to be out of commission for weeks. So her way of thinking is what a lot of people are starting to do. And here at Davis Cosmetic Plastic Surgery, we do a lot of lasers that really involve minimal downtime, but you can see the benefits as time goes on. And sometimes we'll even structure it so that over the course of 6 months, we'll do one a month for about 6 months, where you almost have a 1 or 2 day period of time where your skin may be a little irritated, but you're really never missing a beat. The other thing that she talked about, Sarah Ferguson, was that she really doesn't like the idea of Botox, because she thought it made too much of an immediate result that just looked fake to her. She wanted to be as expressive as she says she always loves to be, and the Botox made her feel too frozen. So she loves the idea of the lasers because she's still able to go after these wrinkles, but she doesn't get that appearance of anything being too drastic. So think about that when you're thinking about all the other modalities that you could do to wrinkle erase. Doesn't have to be a filler. Doesn't have to be something like Botox. It could actually be something that's actually sanding your skin. And you can actually be the captain of the ship and be as aggressive about it as you want to, understanding that there are lasers that are all going to reach the same endpoint at some point. So you could do it with a real aggressive fashion so that you can see the results quicker, but you'll have a little bit more downtime. Or you could try to do it a little bit more in a steady way, and you'll still end up getting the same kind of a result, just be further down the road. So I'm Dr. Stephen Davis at Davis Cosmetic Plastic Surgery, and we'll be talking again soon.